Welcome to Cooking for Baby and Me. Today's featured ingredient is cauliflower, and we'll be making gluten-free cauliflower cakes with bacon, cheddar, and sour cream, and creamy cauliflower soup with red pepper and olives. Joining me in our Morris Black kitchen is Dr. Tecile Andolino from St. Luke's University Health Network and Chef Anthony Bonett.
Hello.
These recipes sound great, so let's get started.
A lot of people find it intimidating to prep a cauliflower. I think once you take your green off, just cut it in half. And once you take the root off, you end up with really nice kind of big florets like that, and then they're very easy to break up at that point.
Okay, great.
Well, that's
so
easy.
You're going to proceed, doctor, to mix all our ingredients for our cauliflower cakes.
Does it matter what order?
It really doesn't. Let's start with the cooked cauliflower. Okay. So we have a whole head of cauliflower that we basically do it on a box grater. I just sauteed it for a few seconds in some butter and took it out, so it's par cooked.
Got it.
Okay. And then you're mixing in the cornmeal, the eggs, the bacon, and the cheese.
And cauliflower is very high in water content.
As well as fiber. So it might be not like the most ideal ingredient to use at the very, very beginning when you're introducing solids for your infant.
Okay.
I usually tell my parents to try to push this off until a little bit later. So wait till they have a few teeth on them.
Okay.
Because it can make some kids a little bit more gassier than others.
Right.
And then parents are worried that they didn't tolerate it very well. And then, especially if you're a first-time parent, you're sitting there freaking out that your kid maybe has an allergy or didn't do well, and then you swore off from cauliflower for the rest of your life.
Just wait a little bit longer.
Yeah, just a little longer.
It's also great for brain development. So
absolutely. So you have choline in there. Mm-hmm. You've got some calcium, which is great for bone health. So you've got a lot of ingredients in there that make cauliflower a great choice.
I
usually say like 9 to 10
here.
Months.
I think you're good here, doctor.
Yes.
Yeah, it looks good. The other recipe we have is a really simple thing. Cauliflower makes a really nice, elegant pureed soup.
Did you saute it all in this pot?
I did. I put the onion, I put the potatoes, and I put the cauliflower kind of in stages. I put a lot of salt and pepper. You want to make sure that you season it real well, because it's kind of a bland vegetable, so it really takes seasoning very well.
And that's why I think it's a little scary to use.
I put some fresh thyme in it. So you're just covering with some stock. You can use veg stock, chicken stock. Okay, and then we got our pan set up. We're going to saute our cakes. So let's make sure we season it up a little more.
And again, a little bit of salt is okay in your diet?
Absolutely. We all need a little bit, especially when we're talking about infants and children. We need some sodium in our diet for growth. People don't think about that, but
no, they don't. Yeah.
It's one of the electrolytes that we need for growth.
And cauliflower is not only good for your child, but it's good for moms and prenatal.
Right. Absolutely.
How is it high in folate?
You can put
it's more of the choline, so it's about skeletal growth. It's about just overall health. So
I put a little bit of tiny bit of heavy cream at the end. Just press them down a little bit, because once the egg heats, there's really nothing else raw in it. It's just the egg.
And when they're ready to flip, the edges get a little brown.
There you go. So we're going to pull the ones out of the oven. Okay, so these are all ready. And you see these are the ones I formed with ring molds. They look a little
perfect.
A little more neat. Okay, you can see our soup's boiling. Okay. Our finished product is here. Roasted peppers work great. You get the nice color with it.
And it makes it look very colorful.
Yeah, to figure out what flavors.
We put a little bit of mixed olives. Get a nice extra virgin olive oil.
Yeah,
we'll put a little bit of extra virgin olive oil.
Gorgeous.
And then for our cakes, we're going ahead and garnish them with just sour cream, which kids love.
These look great and they smell so good. So let's take a little
dig in the soup first.
Of the
good,
soup.
Ladies, go first.
That's extremely flavorful.
Nice.
Excellent.
Let's try our cakes.
It's also very dense, chewy.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah.
Crunchy.
And there was tons of flavor in there.
Mm-hmm.